that a large proportion of the exports of the Irish Republic go to GB, a larger proportion actually than goes to the rest of the EU. And it just seems madness. When looking at it from Northern Ireland, it seems absolute madness that your government has rushed headlong down a route which puts a barrier between not only Northern Ireland and GB, which is our main market, but the Republic of Ireland and GB, which is your main market.
Okay.
Now, you know, any sensible politician who takes that decision and who sticks by it, they must be mad.
So what is the other plan, though? What is the other plan? Because we know Donald Tusk said last week there's a special place in hell for Brexiteers who advocated Brexit without a plan. Are you the person who advocated for Brexit without the plan? Are you the person he was talking about?
Well, I think that first of all, it shows, and the intemperate language of Donald Tusk shows just how disdainful the EU have been in all of these negotiations of the British position, and a total unwillingness to respect the democratic wishes of the people of the United Kingdom. But I mean, there is another plan. The Malthouse plan has been put forward. We have a free trade agreement with no tariffs and no quotas. That should suit the Irish Republic. But secondly, we have a written into a protocol,
why should you get that if you decide to leave the EU? Why should you be allowed to have free trade with the EU and not be a member? That's not fair.
Well, look, if you've asked me about the plan, let me really finish describing the plan for you, and then you can take what you want from it.
Sure, I know from your first sentence that it's not going to work.
Do you want to hear?
Go ahead. Yeah, do.
Well, good. Well, let's go through it. First of all,